you first realized that your son Owen was a little different?
Just around the time he was 3 years old. He stopped talking, he couldn't make eye contact, and his two-year-old speech, you know, I love you, let's get ice cream, just vanished. So he became silent.
And you talk about watching the video before there was a problem and watching it over and over again.
Right.
How frustrating was it, and how many times do you think you watched the video?
Well, you know, I have watched Dumbo and Beauty and the Beast more than I think the guys who made the movie at this point. But it was interesting because Owen, our son, and his older brother, Walt, loved the Disney movies like all kids did in that period. Owen's now 23. But after the onset of the autism, he watched him with a kind of peculiar intensity. It seemed to be the only thing that settled him, that gave him comfort. And after a while, we're like, let's just watch with him. And over time, over years, we realized that he had memorized all of the songs and lyrics, the dialogue, as sound alone, and that if you threw him a line, he'd throw you back the next line. And that's how we opened, really unlocked the key to him. We spoke in Disney dialogue for years, I know. Harry, I'm interviewing presidents during the day, and I'm Jafar at night, or Merlin, or Rafiki. And over time, he got his speech back. It took years. But then developed and invented an emotional language using hundreds of hours of Disney dialogue, which is very powerful.
Talk about that moment when you realize we can communicate with our son. What was that like?
Well, I mean, my wife and I, Cornelia, call it our Helen Keller, Annie Sullivan moment, like in a water. And Owen looked right at us like we had broken through to him. It was when he was saying, just your voice, from the Little Mermaid. He had lost his voice, of course, just like Ariel had. But he was murmuring, Juicervos, Juicervos. Finally, we realized he's saying, just your voice. And he goes, Juicervos, Juicervos. And off we went. And it's extraordinary because it's like that William Blake poem, The World in a Grain of Sand. Well, the DNA of everything is found in all things. The key is being able to see it. And Owen taught us how to see so much in something that we, well, had more or less said, well, that's just a kid's movie. Why bother?
You know, a lot of times when people go through something, they talk about how it makes them better, and
yeah,
makes them stronger. How did Owen's experience enrich your life?
Well, it's interesting because, you know, I have written 6 books now. You know, I have a Pulitzer Prize. Much of it is driven by me searching the world for people who've been left behind. And I didn't realize until some years later that it was because really the most left behind person I met actually was living in the bedroom, my own son. And in so many ways, as we know from our lives, it is the sweet uses of these adversities that summon our best selves. And that's what Owen did for our whole family, our left behind person. Now he's living a terrific life. He will be autistic forever. It's not a spell that gets broken, but he's finding that now more and more he is the hero of his imagination. That very fertile imagination.
Well, let's talk about Owen. What is he doing now?
Well, right now, he went to a college program on Cape Cod, graduated earlier this year, and is in an independent, supported living community. He's got a job, he's got a girlfriend, and he draws like a Disney animator, so he's selling some of his drawings. And for a long time, he said, he feels like a sidekick, that we're all really sidekicks searching for our inner hero. That's us at our best. This is Owen's philosophy. He loves the sidekicks in Disney. Now more and more he's saying, maybe I am the hero after all, which is a lovely shift, I think.
So what would you say to parents of an autistic child? I mean, you even talk about how you and your wife are in denial for a while.
Sure.
You use what you call the A word.
Yeah.
What would you say to parents?
Well, what I would say is that almost every one of the folks in the autism spectrum, like many folks who are a little different, have these passions, these deep interests that actually define them. And they show their deepest capabilities through these passions. Now, instead of cutting that off and saying, go to school and do what they say, we say, live the passion with them. Respect their affinity, you respect them, they'll let you in deeper, and they'll show you their best selves. And my wife often says, enjoy his passion with him. And at the end of the day, you'll be able to express love to him through that language. And they will be able to return it to you. And that's the most important part of this equation. We got to show the love of a parent to a child through Owen's special affinity. the 50 animated movies since Snow White. And now he's emerged, and that's all for the good.
You're speaking to ABC of North Carolina today. What essentially is your message?
Well, you know, this is a seminal organization. This is a destination for families all through this area, and one of the best programs in the country that really does, in a way, what we did in our family and supports this community, this special community. And, you know, we used to say differently abled as opposed to disabled. We used to say that's just a PC term. Well, in a way, they're proving it here. They're giving them the support they need. They're helping them find better lives. And I can't think of a worthier destination for someone's support.
Anything else you'd like to share with us you think we should know?
Well, you know, Owen, I talked to him this morning, and he says, so who are you talking to? I said, an organization like your school and some of the things you've seen. And I said, so you have anything to tell them? And he says, well, I'd go with Merlin. He does all the voices, just like the voice people. He says, well, you know, this love business is a powerful thing. That's Merlin. Arthur responds to Ernest Dunn, greater than gravity. And Owen says to all of them, yes, it's the most powerful force on earth. And it's love that defines rooms like this. And the energy that flows from it, it's us at our best. And it's something everyone everywhere understands deep in their hearts. So that's the message from Owen today.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
No, thank you, Wanda.
Is this your first trip to Winston-Salem?
I've been here a couple times before, okay. But I love this town. It's
well,
great town.
Welcome back.